In this video, I'm gonna cover 5 tips when you edit your talking heads as a YouTuber. You have recorded your A-roll, your talking head, and you're ready to go and edit this so you can create your video to publish it and go live. Now, one of the most common problems that usually YouTubers do is that they don't pay too much attention when they're connecting the clips when we do mistakes. What do I mean by that? Usually on a talking head, it's very common to make mistakes. It's many common to f*** when we talk, and we want to connect these two different sections of the clip that we made a mistake. And if we do it in a way that we're not gonna hide the thing that we made a mistake, it's gonna look a little bit unnatural. So the first tip is to create a cut in and cut out when you create these cuts. And let me show you an example of that. Hey everyone, and welcome to my channel. If you like this kind of content, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and also like this video because it helps rank into the algorithm. Hey everyone, and welcome to my channel. If you like this kind of content, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and also like this video because it helps rank into the algorithm. Did you see how a small detail as the cut in and cut out made a huge difference? Let's go now into Final Cut Pro and see how we can do that, and keep in mind that this is something that you can do in different editing programs as well. We cut the first clip when the audio is finishing, and then we go into the next clip and we go into the inspector panel and we play with the scale and the transform. So for this example, I'm gonna zoom in and then I will go into the y-axis and get a little bit lower so I can have an eye level basically in an imaginary line around here. And the result, simply as that, is gonna have the cut-in effect. You can do that with a cut-out as well. And how we can do that? We can go, let's say, here. Again, I'm gonna blade this. I'm gonna select this and I'm gonna make it again how it was before. So I'm gonna have the cut in and the cut out. My second tip is the speedy rough cuts. When you go into the timeline of your talking head, your A-roll, you're gonna see the waveform just in the bottom. With the waveform, we can understand when we start talking and when we don't talk, or when we're making any pauses. So into my timeline, what I like to do is to go and check the waveform and blade the areas where I don't have music, but I'm not blading, you know, from the beginning. What I do is that I go with the line and I see whenever I have waveforms, I listen to them. And then if I see that I messed up or I made a mistake, I just blade it, cut it, or press the option left edge to start from this segment as well, as you're seeing right now on your screen. The third tip is the long pauses. When we're talking about something, it's very common to create pauses when we're talking. For example, if we say something and we end here, we're gonna continue and say something else. But when you edit that, remember to not give long pause into your edit. So as soon as you end the one word, you need to start the second one. And remember, if you combine that with the cut in and cut out, it's gonna be a seamless talking head. If we say something and we end here, we are gonna continue and say something else. The fourth tip is to use B-roll. So when you talk about something, a great way to cover when you make pauses or you make adjustments or corrections in your talking head is to use B-roll footage. It might be something relevant to what you're saying. If it is a gear review, you can have B-roll footage of this gear. If it's something, whatever you have in mind, you can find a lot of different services in the internet to get B-roll footage if you haven't recorded yourself. Or you can get your camera, go outside and film whatever B-roll you will say on your talking head. And my last tip, my fifth tip, a very useful one. When you go and playback, do you know that you have the option to double the speed of your playback? So if you press L in your keyboard, you can play 2 times faster. So instead of spending 5 or 8 minutes to listen to a talking head, or 10 or 15, I know you're out there, you're doing big A-rolls, you can cut it in half and you can hear not to 100% or but 2 times faster what you're saying, so you can have a basic idea of when you need to cut something, when you need to blade something or put something aside. I hope you found this video helpful and you learned something new today. And if you did that as a reward, don't forget to like this video because it helps ranking in the algorithm. If you have any questions or you just want to say hi, I'm waiting in the comment section down below. And if you liked what you see, don't forget to subscribe with the bell notifications ring on. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Emilio and I will see you in the next video. I have to do the mic drop now. Mic drop.